Full height, half height, deep frame, sonic,
precision sonic,
air jet.
There's a lot of test sieves out there, but deep down, they all do the same thing.
This is WS Tyler's full test sieve lineup. Every single one of these test sieves was made to help you have a perfect particle size analysis operation. And at the end of the day, every single one of these test sieves was made to have particles screen through them and to have an accurate and repeatable particle distribution curve. But why so different, and why so many? Let's start with the basics. If you're just looking to separate particles to get an accurate distribution curve, then our standard sieves will probably do the job. So depending on the sieve, you can go from a 3.5 mesh all the way down to a 635 mesh, which is about a 20 micron opening. And this is a 635 mesh under 11 times magnification. But I should also add that you can exceed the 3.5 mesh opening size and go all the way to an opening size of 5 inches, which is mostly gonna be used for hand sieving as a go, no-go gauge. All of these sieves can either come in brass or stainless steel frames, and the mesh can also come in brass or stainless steel. You can even get a brass frame with stainless steel mesh, but a stainless steel frame with brass mesh isn't really a thing. Now our standard full height sieves can have a diameter of 12 inch, 8 inch, or 3 inch, with 8 inch kind of being the default size. And we also offer 200 millimeter and 300 millimeter test sieves if Imperial isn't exactly your style. Although the 300 millimeter can only be offered in stainless steel, the 200 millimeter can be offered in a combination, or can just be offered in plain old stainless steel. But if you want a more defined distribution curve, we also offer our half-height test sieves, all just as customizable as the full-height test sieves. You have 3-inch, 8-inch, 12-inch, 200mm, 300mm. If you want it, we got it. Oh hey, are you wondering if we have non-standard sieve sizes? We do. We have 6-inch, 10-inch, and even 18-inch.
Non-standard sieve sizes of 6-inch, 10-inch, and 18-inch are only available in stainless steel.
And yes, all of our standard sieves fit in our Rotap Sieve Shaker series, but you will need a conversion kit for the 3-inch test sieves and the non-standard test sieve diameters. But the RX30 was literally built for 12-inch diameter sieves. So keep that in mind. Now we have all of these different sized test sieves, but what if...
That's a big test sieve.
So these guys kind of have two different names. They're either called wet wash sieves or deep frame sieves. And they're only designed for wet sieve particle size analysis. You see, they've got these holes on the sieve skirt for drainage. And they hold a massive amount of volume. Very helpful. And just like our standard sieves, these deep frame sieves come with all the fixings with either brass or stainless or 3-inch, 8-inch, or 12-inch sieve diameters. Now, if you want to run a wet sieve analysis with a Rotap, you can do that, but you would actually just use standard sieves. And of course, you'd have to use a wet sieve analysis setup rather than a dry sieve analysis setup. There is something in there. Well, hello there, little fella. This is a sonic sieve. It's sonic. So these guys are specifically designed for the sonic sifter and verisifter. Their function is basically the same as any other test sieve. You have the mesh and you have the frame, except the frame is made of acrylic, so you can actually see inside the sieve as it's sieving, which is pretty cool. Other than that, the sonic sieve only comes in a diameter of 3 inches, but since sonic sifters usually deal with ultrafine particles, you can instead use a precision sonic sieve. Sonic sieves can go all the way down to a 635 mesh, which is a 20 micron opening, but precision sonic sieves start at a 150 micron opening and can go all the way down to a 3 micron opening, which is just absolutely mind-boggling. This, as you can see, is a 3 micron opening precision sonic sieve, which means that I have to handle it very, very delicately, which is probably why I'm whispering right now. And unlike all of our other types of test sieves, this is the only type that doesn't use woven wire mesh. It uses an electroformed wire mesh, which underneath a microscope looks pretty cool, doesn't it? Anyway, these things are very, very expensive, so I'm gonna put it away before something bad happens. Normal voice. Normal voice. Normal voice. And now we have the Alpine Airjet test sieves. These sieves are specifically designed to run in the Alpine Airjet E200LS. They're also designed with ultra-fine particles in mind, all the way down to a 20 micron opening. They're all stainless steel, they're all 200 millimeters in diameter, and they're all designed to be ran one at a time, so keep that in mind. You can either get the sieve with or without an RFID chip. What is an RFID chip, you ask? Basically, it's a chip that communicates with the Alpine to make your job faster and safer. Let's say you have a number 100 test sieve. The RFID chip will have that information stored on it, and when you load that sieve into the Alpine, the Alpine will know exactly what sieve it is and change the settings for optimal performance.
And it also eliminates user error because the Alpine will basically know if you're using the wrong sieve for your SOP or not. Pretty cool.
All right, I think that's everything. There's so many. And that's W.S. Tyler's test sieve lineup. I hope this gave you a clear start into your particle size analysis experience. But if you want to dive even further into these products, we have a learning center filled with written content to make you an expert. And we also have a W.S. Tyler YouTube channel to give you a more visual approach to learning. And if you have any other questions, our Talk to Us button is only a click away. That'll get you in touch with our many experts on woven wire mesh. Thanks so much for watching. My name's Andrew Kotlar, and I'll see you around in the next video. Bye for now.